We will start very soon. So one more thing, is my screen is visible to you? It's the learning content of Microsoft. Okay, good, very good. So we can primarily discuss a few things and finally we will start our session, just 1 or 2 minutes, okay. So thank you for being response. So actually our classes scheduled for today for VBA and Macro. So all of you are aware of the class topic today. You can respond me through. Yep, today actually this is 7th yes. June and we actually planned for the lecture VBA and Macro. So let me make a little bit introduction about VBA. So what is the meaning of VBA actually? What is the full meaning of VBA? How many participants do you know actually? What is VBA? We have some little participants, so we can talk also, but after when the crowd will be much more, then we'll meet ourselves. So you can engage with me. So who are experienced with VBA among the participants?
I know little about macro. About VBA, it is basically Visual Basic, where we can have some like coding and we can fulfill our few purposes in Excel.
Yes. Thank you very much. Actually, VBA stands for Visual Basic. This is actually the programming language dedicated to use for Microsoft Office program. Remote always move on the wave that Microsoft is going to close the VBA operation, but this is not actually going to happen anymore because all the programs of Microsoft Office runs using VBA. So they have stopped doing some R&D activity, but actually they have not stopped the VBA using Visual Basic for application. So today we are going to do some activity with Visual Basic specifically for Microsoft Excel. So we are not going to outside other like Word or PowerPoint, but this time we are going to learn some key points about Visual Basic. I'm going to show you some example and some resource also I'm going to share with you how we can get some good resource of learning VBA. So you can personally knock me in the mail or just right now, if it is possible to share it through chat box, I can share you a little bit about VBA. I have some collections, online collections basically. So first of all, it is better to prepare yourself for learning VBA because VBA is really very big area. And for the non-programmer specifically, I would say, for the non-programmer, it is really very tough to learn all the options, all the functions, all the ins and outs of VBA. So as a common user, as a common Excel user, just you'll have to equip yourself with the resource, some of the collection of required VBA codes, and then you'll have to understand the basic operation of VBA. Especially for me, I'm also not a programmer, but I can use VBA a little bit, and that's the experience I'm going to share with you all today. So hopefully it will be a good fun. So here I actually tried to show you that I have made some collection of VBA resource online. So here you can make a note, and also you can have this list also from my side, Wiseol, VBA, Excel VBA's fun, Excel Macro Mastery, Excel VBA Help. So Ajoy Kumar, he is also a VBA lover. The Tiger Spreadsheet. These are actually the very famous, well-known YouTube options from where you can have some resource on VBA. And you can also have some VBA with the online resource also some of the website they have also formed. Why is all they have the website, the Stack Overflow, Code VBA, VBAExpress.com, Automate Excel, so a spreadsheet group. So these are actually the designs on online resources for especially the VBA codes. So we can also have this resource at our collection so that we can easily, if we face any problem or if we face any difficulty or if we want to learn something from online, then we can take help from using this resource also. So I can share all this resource to your email also. No problem. So let's get into the Excel operation. So this is actually an Excel operation that I have tried to display some of the topics that is no relevant with the VBA actually. But if you want to use the VBA, how we can go there? The very first step, if I think some of my participants may be at the beginner level, so I'm going very slowly and from the very beginning so that they can have a little bit understanding about the VBA operation. So don't mind, gradually we will move into the deep side also. So the very first thing is that you will have to start working with your ribbon first if you really want to get into the VBA operations. The developer tab is the only option which can be used as a gateway of entering into the VBA operations. So normally when the Microsoft Office software is installed in your PC or you just open a fresh Excel file, you are not getting this tab in front of your eyes. So that will be actually in the form. I'm just doing the reverse activity basically. So I'm just unchecking this. So you are going to have this like activity. So very fast activity that you will have to activate your developer tab. Say after there, you are not going to have any developer tab until and unless you just customize your ribbon and set the checkbox for the developer tab. So the same thing I'm going to do once again, just right click at that position and customize ribbon and find out the developer tab within this area. So developer tabs situated here, just you will have to take this checkbox and finally you will have to click okay button. So you are getting the developer tab. So this is actually the area which we can move through long cut method, that means using the Excel menus. And there is also a shortcut to get into Excel VBA part, that is Alt F11. So Alt F11 is the shortcut for getting into the VBA window. So Alt F11. So when we will press Alt F11, the same thing if we do twice, we will just switch to Excel and VBA. Just Alt F11. Once I'm hitting Alt F11, I'm going to VBA window. And once I'm pressing Alt 11, I'm going to Excel window. So this is also the switching options, because when you are going to apply some VBA code, so definitely you need to check whether it's working or not. Say, I'm just going to take a new Excel file, Control N. So Control N actually the shortcut for opening a new Excel file. And from there, when I'm selecting here, this options, the VBA window is one of them. So VBA window is one of them. Just you need to switch through your mouse or some other means. Other means, that means Alt 11, or just going to hover your mouse and select one, any of them. So here I'm just selecting that one and just activating my Excel workbook also. You can also use Alt Tab to move here and there. So these workbooks, actually there are lots of projects you can have in your PC. So first you'll have to activate your own Excel workbook, which you are going to apply this one. So in this case, this is actually my new Excel workbook. So I will have to double click or just select this one. So if I double click this option, so this VBA editor will be applicable for this one. So two options. So I'm just requesting my participant to keep the mute off. So I'm doing this myself for the very first time. So if there is any noise, please do it by yourself. So this is your honest request for the common purpose. So if anyone wants to talk, please, you can share this in the chat box, or you can also raise your hand so that I can give you the floor for speaking something. So we are talking about the VBA. We are talking about the VBA. So we have already explored the meaning of VBA, that is Visual Basic for Applications. Some of the new participants have joined. That's why I'm just repeating a little bit. And then I have already told about the developer tab, The alternative of developer tab is Alt F11, Alt Alt plus function F11. So that is the shortcut actually. Then we have talked about activate the Excel workbook, activating the Excel workbooks. So WB is a workbook, Excel workbook. So here I have just opened, and this one is that I just created Excel. So just double clicking that one, I have just taken this option. So here I want to add one more thing, that is IDE. So IDE is a terminology that is actually explain integrated development environments, or you can just say it as a text or code editor for any programming language. Say you are practicing Python, or just a minute, Python art solutions, or any type of program. So definitely you need to input your own programming code through an IDE. So this is for the VBA. This is window actually called the IDE, Integrated Development Environment. So first thing, you will have to understand this area first. So this is your Project Explorer. This is the main body of IDE. That means here you're just going to write down your code, and you are going to execute at that region. So first you will have to select your region where you are going to apply this VBA code, and then you will have to execute. So here is the place. So here I have already used some of the provisions, that means the quoted marks, and I can also do it, just write down remember. So that means they don't take it as a executable code. They just confirm me that this is a comment. So these are the some provisions that we're going to explore one by one. So this time I'm just going to explore the vocabulary related to VBA. So now the big questions: what is the use of VBA? So before going into the deep for learning Visual Basic for application, so we need to know what is actually the use of VBA. So if I want to tell you about something, just let me give you an example. Say right now, here are some of my sheets, and I want to add another 10 sheets. So how I can do that? Just let me do it a little bit, some of my example. Let me take that first. I have just hit this 10 sheets. Just say that here, how many sheets are there? I can very easily say that there are 3 sheets actually. But if I have much more sheets, just plus, 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 you can say that there are much more sheets. So if I want to count the number of sheets, how I can do that, let me apply a code. This is adding, just let me find out. I'm taking a little bit of time. The macro counting workbook. This is actually for Word. Okay, this code. So it's very small letter, but you can very, I hope you can see that message screen. So I have just executed a code. How I have do that, I will show you. But I have just executed a code. The total number of sheets of this workbook is 7. The total number of sheets of this workbook is 7. And right now I'm going to hit this 10 sheets button, 10 sheets button. So what will be the total number actually? Previously I have 7 and I have just added 10 sheets. So what should be my actual number? I can add just this one plus this one, just a small Excel operation. 10 plus 7, that will be 17. So if similar way, if I go to execute the same code, counting sheets in workbook, so the total number will be 17. So this can be a little bit execution. If you want to count the sheets, how many sheets are there? And one more thing, say I want to have all my sheets name as per my list. Say I have just write down some provisional name 1, 2, 3. So I have almost 17 names. So I have just write down here the 17 names. And just let me check one more thing. Just let me make a little bit changes so that I can very easily see that the code is actually working. So I want to rename this name up to here. But if I want to do it manually, just this one, just double click this one, that will be name underscore one. If I want to go that way, this is my fourth sheet, just right click, rename. So rename, that will be my name underscore five. If I want to rename here, or you can just write shortcut Alt H O I, Alt H O I. That is also the shortcut for doing the rename of your function. So if I do that manually one by one, really it takes much time. Really it takes much time. So if I want to do it the single click, then how I can do that? So let me execute a little bit a single different code of where I have got the rename advanced macro counting old shortens rename multiple sheets. Okay, just hit that button. So see the magic. Let's check the rename sheets. Let's check the rename sheets. So I have put my the seventh sheets. Here is the seventh check. I have just put name 17, the last one. Control right arrow. This is a small arrow. This is a small arrow that is actually used to go one by one. But if I press my control key and then hit that one, I can go extreme right side. So this is actually name 70. So let me check once again. Say I want to write down some different names. Say different df underscore one. Or you can use some rand between function also. But here is a formula. So let me check once again to apply some formula also. So here I have just used some text part, and I'm going to use some random number. So random number 1, 2, 5, 6. Close, enter. Just let me drag it down. So here are my different names actually, and I want to check control to VV. Just I have converted the formula to values. So this time, if I go to apply the same things once again, just a single click, just it takes a single click to change all the names. So don't be confused. I'm going to explore all the codes one by one. So I'm just showing you one or two examples how I can apply VBA for our day-to-day activities. I'm not going to deep into the coding part because I'm also not so expert up to that level. But I think this type of activity, you can also use as being a non-programmer. So these are actually the main operative part. How we can use VBA for our practical purposes. So let me make it clear how I have done this. Okay, so this is actually a fresh blank Excel workbook. So what you can see here over the part, this is actually called the Excel ribbon. So in the ribbon, you may have four different types of tab. Four different types of tabs. So what are the different types of tab? I'm going to explore one by one. The first one is default. Default, that means when you are going to open an Excel file, you are going to have this home, insert, page layout, and this type of activities. And the second one is hidden. Hidden, that means not activated, not activated, not activated, not activated. Okay, so this is one thing I have already done, developer tab. It was not added to your file, and just I have added it. And the third one is ad hoc. Third one is ad hoc. Ad hoc means, say you have a data, one enter, and you have the name here. Just write down, just to the extreme part, voltage. So I'm going to convert this as a table, control T, my table as a header. Okay, so when I'm hitting there, just look at the ribbon, there's some gap. And if I hit that one, you are getting some design option, So these are actually called the ad hoc tabs. So when applicable, it will be activated. Say I have taken a screenshot, so like that way I have that screenshot, and I'm going to paste that one. So if I select that one, you can say that there is a format tab. There is a format tab. So if you insert an image, you can also have a different type of format tab. So if I select this one and insert a pivot table existing workbook, and I just want to put here a pivot table. So if I select that one, you can have the analysis and design tab. So these are actually called the ad hoc tabs. These are actually called the ad hoc tabs. So I want to go back to my initial position, just control Z. Okay, I have just removed all the data. So I have already got three different types. And the last and final one, this is actually customized. This is going to be very, very important for us, customized tab. So I think you have already get some idea from my Excel ribbon. So here are some customized tab, adding row, column sheets, worksheet, merge, split, consolidate, advanced macro, Habib's tab. So these are the customized tab that I have created for my own purpose that I've already shown by some examples here. Let me give a little bit break. Yes, my lecture is understandable for all of you, or I'm just speaking on my own way? Someone please add some.
No, it's okay. Just carry on.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. So the last one I talked about, the customized one. So customized one, by following what step we can do that. Just right click and customize ribbon. After that, this is okay. And just here, this is your visible part. This is your visible part. So if I want to do a little screenshot, I can. So this is actually your visible part. So if I hit this check marks is there, that will be added to the ribbon of the Excel part. But here are two things I want to add. So one information for all of you, I'm just using the free version of Zoom, and in free version there are 40 minutes time limit. So I would like to request you to join when this session will be finished. I'm going to re-enter the session once again after finishing this 10 minutes. Okay. So is the message is clear to you? Just write down if you want up to just yes or no. The Zoom session will be discontinued at 10:35 or 30. So you just use the same link to join my session again. So here are two things I want to add here. This is the new tab and new group. So new group is used to add already added tabs. New groups is used to already added tabs, but new tab is totally new. So how I can do that? Just let me show you practical demonstration. So here I have just clicked new tab. So here a set of tab, and under the tab there is a subgroup. So just selecting this one, there is a button rename, or you can just right click your mouse, you will get options rename. So rename actually stand for changing the existing name. So here I'm going to input a name. Input new name. I'm just write down the name, input new name, and selecting OK. And finally, you can also change your group. So here I'm going to open. So I want to apply new tab. Just I have given the name of the tab. Okay. And finally, you'll have to click OK. So the thing is that you will get a new tab. Is it available? So where it has gone? So input new name. Actually, my cursor was selected up to that position. Don't worry, we can also change the position also. Just right click down and then select if you want to choose that you want to keep at the end of the list, or you can put there, just write down here, just put down, or you can keep it back. So Qtools, I'm not going to use Qtools right now. So I can just uncheck that part also. So this time, okay. So now it's visible. Input new names. Sorry for the interruption. So but actually we have got a new tab. So this is input, a new name. This is my new tab. But how I can add this macro into this part? So select customized ribbon options, and just on the right side, on the left side, there is an options. So this is actually the most popular used command. These are the most popular used command. So you can also add this option to that part also. Just select that one and select that one and just add, or you can just move up and down also using the arrow key. But my point of interest is not there. My point of interest is in that areas, because I'm going to work with macros. So my interest is the above down arrows, the upper down arrows. So when I'm hitting that one, so it's showing me some of the options that are the popular commands, command not in the ribbon, all commands and macros. So this time I'm going to use macros. So this time I'm going to use the macro one. So when I'm selecting macro, you can see there are lots of files. But one thing I hope you have already noticed, in every course, there is a word personal. Few of them maybe about it's not available, but like in that cases, it's not available. But all the code contains the name personal and then a name. So there is a meaning actually. I'm going to explore after the that part. So if I want to add that one, say just selecting that one or selecting that one or selecting that one, I just want to add. So it will be available there. Say, let me add one more some word. Add, rename, add. So workbook, add. And finally, hit OK. So I have got that. So here I have just added. Okay. My goodness. So I clicked a different tab. So I have already added this five options. So this doesn't look so good. So you can make some editing also. Just right click again, customize ribbon. And this is actually the tab I have added. So here I can do some customization. Say right click and rename. So here you are getting some of the options. Say the code designated as activated R1C1. So I'm just writing a name, activating R1C1 style. Okay. And I'm just going to use any of the symbol for your convenience. You can just use any one of your symbols. Say right that one, I'm just choosing and click OK. So this has changed. And finally, if I click OK and go there, just among the four, it has been changed. So what the thing will happen? Say the column name has become 1, 1, 1, 2, 3. So this tab is actually used to convert from ABC to 1, 2, 3. So if I go to the file options, let me bring it back once again. Options and from formula, if I uncheck this button, okay, it will come back to ABC. But the code I have added there, if I hit that one, it is going to convert ABC, 1, 2, 3. So this is the code behind that saved code. So, okay. So I think it's now clear to you how I have created that all tabs. One by one, you will have to collect the VBA and then you will have to add to the personal macro. And I'm going to show you how to add code to your personal macro. Then you can add it to the ribbon. And finally, just you can use that one. Say, yeah, let me put 1, 2, 3. Okay. I want to put at that position more five columns. Say you have a table, just highlight this with a color and just keep your cursor there. And you want to put five columns more, just that one. So very easily you can have this five columns. Just if I check this by using a formulas, that is columns, and just select that region and finally close the bracket and hit enter. So I'm getting the value five. So very easily I can add five columns. So in many cases when we're working with multiple tables or we're developing some reports, so we need to add some rows and columns. So by this way, I can use say 20 columns. So it's going to give me add 20 columns exactly. I don't need to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then right click and finally insert. So this is the alternative of that codes. Now the crucial parts, personal macro workbook. Now the crucial parts. So personal macro workbook, personal macro workbook. So how I can have this personal macro workbook? So here, let me show you one thing. So this is a project. So when you are going to use it in your Excel file, you are not going to have this file. There is no file called personal macro in a default condition. So definitely you'll have to create by your efforts. This will have to create by your efforts. So I can add here a query. I think you have already faced it in your life if you have used VBA in your own works. So that is, you have a Excel file, you have an Excel workbook, and you have a macro.
I think within 40 seconds, the session will end. Better you close the live and...
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for suggesting. So I am cutting this session here. And hopefully I'm going to start the second session. It will be available in 20 or 30 seconds. Okay?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.